Hey students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to another Saxon Dynamics video with me, Dr. Loay Alzube. This is going to be the third and the last video of our discussion of the center of gravity and the centroid, in which we're going to explain the steps in order to solve a problem, which is about finding the centroid of area for a particular problem. Let's begin talking about the steps that we need to follow in order to solve problems in which we're going to identify center of gravity, center of mass, or the centroid. It's all the same, but we're going to apply it for a different quantity. What are the steps to determine the centroid of an area? So step one would be, we need to choose an appropriate differential element, dA. We want to identify the area. We will select a dA, a differential element of the area, at a general point x and y in my Cartesian coordinate system in which that my area is located. We have a hint or a general rule in which that if y is easily expressed in terms of x for the area that we are going to identify, for example, if y equals x squared plus 1, so if this formula represents my area, then we're going to use a vertical rectangular element. So remember that we are assuming that we have a two-dimensional problem and you have an area in the x and y. And so if y can be expressed in terms of x, I will use my differential area element to be a vertical one. If it's the other way around, x can be easily represented by y, I'm going to use a horizontal area differential element. So this is my dA, and that's dA, depending on how I can write the formula. So that's step one, doing my differential area element and locating it in an x and y in a two-dimensional, you know, Cartesian coordinate system. So what's the next step? We will want to express dA in terms of the differential element dx or dy. And what do we mean by that? So let's say if I have this two-dimensional area and I said, well, okay, I have my y, that's the height, and I identify distance dx to be on the x-axis, my area dA is going to be y dx. And that's what we mean by expressing dA in term of either dx or dy. So that's what we did here. Third step will be determining the coordinate x tilde and y tilde of the centroid of the rectangular element in term of the general form. So remember, x tilde and y tilde all the time, they are about the infinitesimal differential element, which is in this case dA. So what are the coordinates x tilde and y tilde? And we need to express them x tilde and y tilde in terms of x and y. I know there's a lot of expression of different variables in terms of other variables. I'm going to explain that more in the example that we're going to talk about in a bit. After doing that, we will express all the variables and integral limits depending on x and y and do the integration. Remember, the thing that we would like to find is one of the examples, x bar equals, let's say, the integration of x tilde dA over the integration of dA. That's to find the centroid of an area. And the same will be for y bar equals y tilde dA over the integral of dA. So we need to identify these two if we want to do this in two dimensions. And then we will do the integration. Keep in mind that the same procedure, if we want to find the center of gravity and the center of mass, but instead of having dA as our differential element, we will have it dW or dm, which is the d mass. Let's put this into practice in solving one of the problems. This is an example. So if you're given this schematic with an area, shaded area here, and if you note that we have an x and y, so this is a two-dimensional problem, we were given the curve or the formula that represents this curve, which is y equals x cubed, and we are limiting our area by an x on the x-axis from point 0 to 1 and on the y-axis from 0 to 1 as well. We would like to find for the area shown, the centroid location, this is an area, x bar and y bar, and we need to see how we're going to follow the steps. That's going to be our plan. So let's start. Step one, if you recall, it's easier to use a vertical differential element for the area, dA. And that is what we have here, the vertical differential element. So that's and also it's going to be a rectangular strip, and that's what we have here. If I want to put it there, I will say, okay, step by step, I'm going to create a differential area element here, right? And that is going to be my DA. And you can say that here for your DA, I have the length, which is Y. And I'm going to identify a differential element on the x-axis as dx. And that's going to be the width of the rectangle. And you can see that we assume that the width dx, because it's a smaller. After doing the vertical strip, we need to identify our differential element, which is dA. If we want to write dA in terms of x and y, what should we be doing? So it's a rectangle, so it's the length multiplied by the width. The length is y, that's my y, and the width is dx because that's a smaller part, so that's your area. Also, if you remember, y equals x cubed, so I want to write, if I have my expression in dx here, I need to make sure that I'm writing everything in the terms of x. So what is y in terms of x? It's x cubed, and that is your dA. So that's my differential area element. That's step two. Now, step three will be, I want to identify x tilde and y tilde. And x tilde and y tilde are the coordinates of the centroid of dA. We need to keep that in mind. So when I talk about x tilde and y tilde, those are the coordinates of dA. What I would like to find is the coordinates of the entire area, which are the centroid of the area, and those are x bar and y bar. So what is, if I'm looking at dA here, what is my centroid for the area, the red rectangle? So x is going to be in the middle here, right? So x tilde equals to x, and this is a rectangle. So if I have a height of y, my centroid is going to be in the middle. So that's y tilde is going to be y over 2. So, and that's where we got x tilde equal to x, because that's this location, and y tilde equals y over 2, and that's half of the height, and yx cube over 3, so y tilde is going to be x cube over 2. Now I have all the elements that will allow me to identify x bar equals to x tilde dA over dA, and y bar equals y tilde dA over the integral of dA. So how can we do this? So x bar is, as we said before, is the integration of x tilde dA over the integral of dA. I need to now substitute each element with what it's corresponding to. So x tilde is x, that's the first thing. dA is x cubed dx, that's what we have here. The integral of dA is the integral of x cubed dx. And if you remember, our limits goes from 0 to 1 on the x-axis, right? So if you do this, this is x to the power 4. So this is the integral of x to the power 4 dx. And that's the integral x cubed dx. The integral of x 4 is going to be x 5 over 5. And that's what we have here. And the limits from 0 to 1. And the other one is going to be x 4 over 4 from 0 to 1. That's what we have. When you substitute the values, that's 1/5. Divided by 1/4, and that's 0.8 meters. So my location on the x-axis is actually at 0.8 for the center of area. Now, what about y bar? Same procedure, y bar equals y tilde dA over the integral dA. So what is y bar? Y bar is y over 2, that if you recall from the previous slide, and y is equal x cubed over 2. Now y is x cubed, so that's x cubed over 2. Your dA is still x cubed multiplied by dx. If you do the multiplication, it's x to the power 6, and then you divide the integral by, if you integrate x to the power 6, it's going to be x to the power 7 divided by 7, and you have a 2, that's 1/14, and the area is the same thing as we did the previous on x bar, and then you will end up with 1/14 divided by 1/4, and that's your location on the y-axis, and that is going to be the point here, 0.2857, and exactly this is where your centroid of the area, 0.8 and 0.28, and that's where you will find the location for the centroid in the area that we were given actually to find in. I hope that this example provided you with the necessary information of how can we formulate and use formulas to calculate the center or determine the center of area. You can apply the same for the center of mass, center of gravity, and the center of length.